I'll let you find it. It had rained all week by Saturday. The rain still hadn't stopped. Floppy looked miserable. He hadn't had a good walk for ages. But old Floppy said Kiba. Later, Saturday it stopped raining, so Kiba opened the back door and looked out. He could see a patch of blue sky. "Good boy, Floppy," said Kiba. "It has stopped raining at last." Floppy picked up his lid in his mouth and gave a little whimper. "I'll see who will take you for a walk," said Kiba. The fans were playing a game. It was hard to tell who would win. "Shall we take Floppy for a walk?" asked Kiba. "Not just now," said Chip. "Biff and I are locked in combat. Mom and Dad were putting a bookcase together. Can we take Floppy for a walk?" pleaded Kiba. "He hasn't had one for ages." "We can't," said Mom. "Not at that moment. Let him into the garden for now." Just then, Kiba's friend Lee came to the house, to the door. "Do you want to come to my house and play?" asked Lee. "Grandpa Chan has made some fortune cookies." "Sorry, Floppy," said Kiba. "No work for you at that moment." At the moment, the boys loved Grandpa's fortune cookies. Kiba broke one open and pulled out the tiny slip of paper from inside it. It said, "Candy this. I like see this plenty often. I'd like to take Floppy for a walk," said Kiba. "That would be a kind deed." "Well, Button needs a walk too," said Lee. "Can we take both dogs out, Grandpa? That will be a kind deed." Grandpa said it was a good idea. "The dogs can have a good run," he said. They were along, went along a path that led to dewdrop down. The boys loved going there, and so did the dogs. It had humps and bumps, and there were bushes to hide behind. It was a great place to play chase. Lee and Kiba ran up a steep hump as they reached the top. The earth suddenly slid away. The boys tumbled to the bottom. Grandpa Chan ran up to the boys. He helped them both up. "Are you all right?" asked Grandpa. "The ground gave way, said Lee. "We are just a bit muddy, that's all." Kiba looked at the place where the ground had slipped away. A black object was sticking out of the earth. "What is that, Grandpa Chan?" he asked. "Oh goodness," exclaimed Grandpa Chan. It might be dangerous. It looks like a very old explosive. It was probably dropped in World War II. We'd better get well back," said Lee. Grandpa Chan phoned the police. Soon a police car rushed up. Grandpa Chan took the police officers to the place where the ground had slipped away. "It could be an explosive," said an officer. This is a job for the experts," said another officer. "Meanwhile, we must not take any chances. We'll have to tape off a large area." The other police officer unrolled a large reel of blue tape. It wasn't long before a disposal unit came. One of the experts went to look. Lee and Kiba were excited. "Wow," said Lee. "Maybe we will see them exploded." The disposal expert came to talk to the boys. He was grinning. "It wasn't a job. It isn't a job for us after all," he said. "I think it's some kind of part, but it is very old, and it is an artifact, and it needed a history expert." The men over the ground with metal detectors. "There may be other artifacts under the ground," one of them said. "This could be an ancient bridge or burial ground. Burial ground. Later, a woman called Anna came and carefully dug the board out of the ground. She scrubbed some earth from the neck. Then she peered inside. This is so exciting," she said. "I'm hoping there is something interesting inside it." Gently, Anna tipped the pot up onto a cloth. About 30 gold coins slid out even gasped. "These coins are hundreds of years old," she said excitedly. "They show a Saxon king called Edwald. He was king in about 620. Kiba and Lee looked at one of the coins through a magnifying glass. "I've never seen anything so old," said Lee. "King Edwald had a big nose," laughed Kiba, "and a big chin." Then a television crew came. "We'd like to cover the story on the news this evening," a man said. He looked at Lee and Kiba. "Now just tell us how you found the boat with all the gold coins in it." Next, the crew spoke to Anna. "The boy and the grandfather did the right thing," she said. "There may be more things to find. This could be the site of a Saxon village here. One dewdrop down. It is very exciting." Back at home, she brushed up to Kiba. "Guess what?" he said. "I'm the winner. I beat Liv. But only just. Well, you should have come on the hog with us," said Kiba. "It was fantastic." "We've finished the bookcase," said Dad. "Did you have a nice hog?" asked Mom. Kiba was bursting to tell everyone his news. But he didn't. "It was really interesting," he said. Then he turned on the television. Everyone gasped when the news item came on. The reporter said that the two boys had found a Saxon artifact. Lee told the reporter how they had found it when the ground slipped away. "I wish we'd gone on the walk now," said Beth. "It would have been better than playing a silly old computer game." "Plant good deeds like seeds," said Kiba. "You'll be amazed what they grow into." "What are you talking about?" asked Biff. "There had been at Saxon Village on Dewdrop. Down the children went to see it. Anna was there to show them round. It's an excavation, said Anna. It means we find where the village was by digging. It doesn't look much like a village, said Chip. It is just a lot of pits and trenches. Saxon houses were made of wood, said Anna. So there is nothing left of them, but we can't tell where they stood. This is an exciting find, said Anna. It's a gold band. It is a bit crumbled, but it has some Latin writing on it. It looks like one of Grandma's fortune cookies, lovely. It was thanks to the fortune cookies we took the dogs for a walk, Lee went on. Yes, said Kiba, the fortune cookie was right. Kind days are like cities, plant them often. We planted a good deed, and it grew into finding a Saxon village. I've never made fortune cookies before, Grandpa laughed. We didn't have them in Hong Kong. When I grew up, they